Hey friends, it's Akidiris. Now, let me begin this video by saying that I hope a lot of you are doing okay today. I know these past couple of days have been pretty hectic on social media, on the internet, even on the news, so given all the drama that has happened, can't say all the heat has died down. However, I hope that this video can sort of lighten the mood for some of you with an Otaku Monthly Favorites. So without further ado, welcome everybody to another episode of Otaku Monthly Favorites, where this is a series that I do at the end of every month, or at least try to, where I share with you guys different anime series, different manga, different anime and otaku related things such as figures, movies, artists that I've been introduced to within that given month. And to begin, I'm really excited to share with you guys an anime film that I saw called Mary and the Witch's Flower. But before I get into that cute transition. And we're back. But yes, Mary and the Witch's Flower. Now, a lot of you are looking at this thinking, is this a new Ghibli film? Yes and no. That's the answer. Long story short, Hayao Miyazaki has basically been on hiatus over and over and over again. And there is someone that works with him called Yona Bayashi, who has been the one behind films such as Arrietty and When Marnie Was There. Because Miyazaki's on hiatus, Yona Bayashi creates Studio Ponic and gets a lot of the team members from Ghibli to go to that studio. And so the first film that they decided to work on was Mary and the Witch's Flower, but Miyazaki had nothing to do with this project. Now, the movie comes out on January 18th. It's not out yet. I just had the privilege of watching it thanks to the people over at GKids, who are this video's sponsor, and they will also be doing a giveaway for 2 tickets to the movie, as well as some Mary and the Witch's Flower merchandise. So if you guys want to enter the giveaway, I will put a link in the description, not only to the giveaway, but also where you guys can go buy movie tickets for Mary and the Witch's Flower. So I want to really make a full-fledged review on this, but I'm going to have to wait until the movie comes out. But I will say this, Mary and the Witch's Flower is going to look, feel, and sound like a Ghibli film. But getting rid of comparison with Ghibli for a second here, animation-wise, I thought it was pretty damn flawless. The design for a lot of these characters are really well done. And the voice acting, I didn't mind. So I saw it in English dub, and I know a lot of people are against English dub, but before you put up your pitchforks, I personally have not really been against a lot of Ghibli's decisions for their English dub actors. Now, you could blame it on nostalgia. So with this movie, just like the rest, I didn't mind it. A lot of them have very heavy British accents. I thought it was very fitting to the atmosphere. I thought that they fitted the characters. So they did a really good job on that, and I'm sure they did a lot of work to try and fit everything together. Story-wise, there is so much I want to say about it. There's a lot of things that I feel like that they took from with Ghibli films such as Kiki's Delivery Service, Spirited Away, Howl's Moving Castles, all of the really big hits. I feel like they took a lot of the magical tropes for that of whatever made those great and tried to comprise it all into this film. But yes, Mary and the Witch's Flower comes out in theaters January 18th, and there is a giveaway for the merchandise and 2 tickets to see the movie. Again, links will be in the description below. The next thing I want to introduce to you guys is just a quick shout out to Sebastiano Serafini. He's a really good friend of mine and Joey's. He recently came out with a music video that we also helped him out with. You'll see a little bit of Easter eggs with us in it. So if you guys want to see that, feel free to go to the link down below. And also, there is another music video that I have shouted out in the past, but if you guys haven't seen that, go watch that as well if you guys are interested. The next thing I'm going to introduce is an artist that I'm pretty late on talking about. His name is Kenshi Yonezu. A lot of you Boku no Hero Academia fans have probably heard that name once or twice. I'm really excited to share this guy because not only can I talk about someone that I'm taking an interest to, but also music. So it's meeting in the middle of both like anime, otaku, and my love of music. Kenshi Yonezu has done not only Boku no Hero Academia, he also did the ending or one of the endings for March Comes in Like a Lion. He did quite a collection of Vocaloid songs. However, his name did not really pop up to my attention until I saw the Uchiage Hanabi collaboration that he did with Daoko. I was interested to see like whose voice that was because it sounded so familiar, and then I was like, oh, I have heard him in anime before. He has admittedly said that a lot of his influences with his style was Bump of Chicken, Asian Kung Fu Generation, Rad Wimps. So if you guys want to listen to some songs of him, I'll link his channel down below. And the last 2 things I'm going to be introducing in this video are 2 clothing brands, which I don't usually do in the Otaku Monthly Favorites, but they're otaku and anime related. So for those of you cloth junkies out there that want to know of some otaku clothing, here they are. One of them is Park Harajuku, and I'm going to be going to Japan in a few weeks, and I need to go see this store. So I found them at random on Instagram, and they also have a lot of Omocat stuff there as well. Omocat is a really popular sort of otaku and anime clothing brand. And Park Harajuku is sort of like another sub clothing brand that also collaborates with Omoket as well. I actually got one of the hoodies on Christmas by Joey. He went over to Park Harajuku after I showed it to him. And they have like original characters for their brand. I'll put a link in the description below, not only to their Instagram, but also their official website. So if you guys want to go, the address will be on their website, which is in the link below as well. And the second clothing brand is the one that I'm currently wearing right now. But the clothing brand is called Kawamochi. I've known about these guys for a long time, and I didn't get to see them in person until they actually came to a fan meet that we did in Amsterdam. I'm a little late to this. Those of you that follow me on Instagram know I posted a picture with me wearing this hoodie a few weeks ago. So they're an otaku slash anime based clothing brand in Amsterdam. And the hoodie that I'm wearing is a reference to the World's album of Porter Robinson. The quote on the back is from the song Flicker. It's nice and thick, it keeps me warm, and there's holes for my thumb because I'm a hipster. I don't know why I said that. Do hipsters like holes for their thumbs? Links to them, along with everything else, will be in the description below. So that was everything I wanted to introduce for this month's Otaku Monthly Favorites. Also, one thing I wish I could have showcased in this video is the Akira vinyl, because my parents got me a record player for Christmas, and now my record collection is growing immensely and rapidly because I keep going to the record store every day now, and I saw online that there is an Akira vinyl, and that blows my mind. So if anybody has that, just know I am internally screaming of jealousy inside if any of you have it. I don't know what's preventing me from doing it. I think it's because I physically want to see it. Should I get it? So, I appreciate you guys for watching, and subscribe to my channel for more anime and otaku-related content, and I will see you guys
in the next video.
Bye!